morning, sir.
How are you?
How are you?
See
you. You as well.
Of
course.
I'm Mike.
Adam.
I'm a master plumber. Here's my card. Here's information on our maintenance plans.
Great. Thank you.
All right.
Booties on.
Got a soft lockout number 2, they tell me, right?
Soft lockout 2.
And is it running or not running?
Not running at all. And something's dripping too. I thought.
You got a big Alpine, huh?
Yeah.
You thought what?
So when we had that huge rainstorm, I was smelling like, it wasn't sewer gas, but like, musty water.
Okay.
The condensate goes from here all the way down there to an HVAC machine. So I thought it was the pump. It might be the same thing, but the pump, it looked like the pump wasn't working yesterday morning.
Okay.
So I was like, oh, the pump's clogged up. That's what's happening.
Possibly.
I cleansed it.
Got the vinegar there, I see.
Yeah, did some vinegar, and I made sure it was working, and that didn't cure it. But now this red pipe, that red pipe in there is dripping.
Okay.
Also, so.
It's probably cold. When's the last time I had any service, maintenance, any repairs?
I had like full, full disclosure, I'm under a maintenance with somebody else, but then
with them or somebody else?
Yeah, with them. But
then what happened? They can't come out?
On a Sunday? No.
No?
On a Sunday.
Really?
Not as good as you.
So I guess they don't really offer 24/7 service.
You would think. I mean, I didn't want to call it an emergency, so sorry.
Yeah, no, I hear you.
But then the last thing was, so like, I work home on Friday, I'm home on Friday, so.
Okay.
Oh, let's turn on the heat and see if it's working. It's October, and that's obviously when it went on for a minute. I know it did because
I heard.
And switches back there.
Yep. All right. Let's see what it does.
I like your YouTube videos.
Thank you.
Very cool.
All right, we'll see what it does.
100% know what I'm looking for, but it smelled like it was.
Yeah, number 2.
I think the smell is gone.
How big is the house? How many square feet?
5,000.
Oh, okay. That explains why the size of the boiler, then. It's a big boy.
Well, it's a lot of different zones, also.
But also the size makes a difference, though.
The house is hodgepodge.
285. All right, so you have the original high limit sensor in there. And that is probably the reason why. Because the condensate trap is not clogged. Oh, someone actually was cleaning that before. All right. Let's try that. Let's see what we got. Got rid of one. Temp switch, air pressure switch. I would have bet money on that, but let's do a little restart. Nope. Okay.
Something about jacking the heat zone that's different than just getting normal shower water and
no.
Okay. It's a crazy coincidence that that's the day it blows out, though.
Yeah. Oh, that's good. All right, let's check our condensate float. Yep, condensate float. No bueno. Condensate float filled with cocky from the bottom of the boiler. Like all the crap in the bottom of the boiler. What kind of chemical are you down here? A laundry sink without any chemical. That's a first. Any kind of dish soap? You have a
hand soap.
If it'll work. We'll try that.
Fancy
Thank
soap.
You. Okay, some more. Nasty. This actually works, believe it or not. Yeah, if you want to pour some on there. Cool. So they took the front cover off and scrubbed the inside of the boiler at the beginning of this. You said in April, I think you said?
I think it was like March, April.
Really?
Yeah.
Maybe they didn't clean out the trap then. But there was evidence that someone was in there already because there's another ring there.
Yeah.
So.
From memory, they were like chipping away at some scaling.
Oh, yeah, that probably makes sense, but maybe they just neglected to clean out the trap.
Does that trap go to the external pump?
Yes.
Is that why it would smell? Or is
no.
That really coincidence?
No, it's coincidental.
I'm having too many coincidences in this house.
Yeah, that's for you.
It's an amazing thing. It's like the number of times, like,
let's take the trap out and clean it. Seen better days. Alright. Let's clean this out. Here.
Snap a photo.
And there. And
you want to take a photo for that.
And it goes a few days a shot? Nah. This boiler will run, you know, maybe 3, 4, or 5 times a day just to maintain temperature of the tank. Alright, so I would recommend that you have them come here and have them do another test of this, the way it turned on, that little thud,
yeah.
Is that could be tweaked a little bit. It should be a little bit better. Again, I know you have a service plan with this company, yeah. So I don't want to step on anyone's toes.
Oh,
but also, the first thing I checked is called the high limit sensor.
Yeah.
It's the first sensor right there with that red little... All right. So, is anything closed or what's going on here? Why is it doing that? You have a rag or a towel? Maybe this one?
Yeah,
I just wanna. I don't want the water to get under you. All right, so why do we have that happening? That's empty. The pressure is normal. It's like that there.
I mean, I didn't have water like that, obviously.
Yeah, no, but. There's that. And it's still going, too. You have a bucket down here at all? We're going to have to catch some of this water. Well, that is weird. Now it's running the way it should, 140 degrees. We have hot water here. Running at 100%. But maybe for a second something was closed off, but that's open. 150, 151, 98%, slowly dropping. 97%. Everything appears to be normal. Back to 99%, back to 100. So now we have demand. We have a zone. Zone 1's calling. One of the space heating zones are running. The temperature dropped down. Interesting. It's like it wasn't moving water. Supply, return. Everything's heating up. 130 degrees, running at 100%.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, finished up that service call with a few reminders to the homeowner. Since they have an active maintenance plan with another contractor, it's best that they reach out to them and have them double check everything, make sure they do a combustion test, and maybe, just maybe, take a look at that swirl plate. You guys who know what I'm talking about. But I'm glad to see there's a neutralizer on that, a very nice clean install. I don't know why that condensate float in that trap got so much cocky on it like that, but maybe, just maybe, it was overlooked. Maybe. I'd like to give everyone the benefit of the doubt. And I know the plumber. They do great work, and that's why I didn't put a sticker on it. Otherwise, I would have put a Mikey Pipes sticker. Was here. Thank you so much for watching. Remember, folks, if you live in the Long Island, New York area, and you're tired of getting bamboozled by your HVAC provider, pick up the phone, give me a call, 516-348-6300, or save time, book your appointment online at pipedoc.net. Services start at $89 for a service call. Thank you so much for watching. Catch you in the next one. Be well, God bless, stay safe.